gluten-free almond nut chocolate
tart. Does it justify the $30? Class is 8 hours in a day on a Saturday. I felt guilty for feeling stressed out. You have more time. You at home. Why are you so stressed out? And then motivated, overwhelmed, a bit burnout. $30. And then at first I was dying. I like work again, then dinner, then work again. Wait, there's no break. We have a candle here. It's broken. It's ugly. But yeah, either have a routine when you wake up or have a routine when you go to sleep.
Hi everyone. I'm Kai.
I am Min.
And welcome back to another episode on Rebuilding You.
Long time no see.
Long time no see.
I think the last time we filmed was more than a month ago. Yeah.
Yeah, so today we're gonna have like a mukbang session where we'll just be catching up, and then we have some food here that we got from Kenny Hill's Bakers.
Yay!
Yeah, so we have pesto pasta.
And it smells very good.
Yes.
Tiramisu cronut.
Yes. And gluten-free almond nut chocolate
tart.
Yes. Since we're giving shoutouts, shout out to Lillian and Cole. I don't want to show you guys my candle. But yes, we have it's a candle broken. Here. It's broken, it's ugly, but yeah.
But it smells really good. It's lychee and black tea.
For those who want to get scented candles and you don't know which scent to get, I would recommend this scent because it's very light.
Yes.
But you can still smell it.
Yeah, it smells really relaxing.
Okay. I'm glad you like it. Okay. Let's eat!
Okay. How have you been?
I've been good. I think nothing much has happened in the past month. I've only really done in my FYP and my ACCA paper. But I think we'll talk about my ACCA paper. Yeah. My ACCA class is 8 hours in a day on a Saturday. So reaction.
Eight hours
is not bad. I prefer it to be in a single day than to have it like last time when I did my internship. It was Thursday and Friday. At night, right, I wanted to fall asleep. But yeah, anyways, at the same time while I'm studying for my paper, I was also doing my FYP.
Yeah.
Which was like, I mean, I felt very bad, you know, that I felt stressed. I felt guilty for feeling stressed out.
Why?
Because I feel like this is very normal. I'm having classes at home. I'm not traveling as much. I'm supposed to have extra time to study, right? But I cannot study more. Yeah, you get what I mean?
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah, it's like you have. But like before MCO, you had this many hours. Now I have this many hours, but I cannot study this
many
hours.
But you're putting in this many hours.
Yeah, I can only put in this many hours. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah, and then I feel very guilty to be stressed out. Because I tell myself, like, you have more time. You can stay at home. Why are you so stressed out? And then, I felt very, demotivated? I think it was a mixture of a lot of different kinds of feelings. Demotivated, overwhelmed, a bit burnout. Yeah, because it was a lot of things coming in together at the same time. And I felt a bit pressured during that time.
I think every student, they will also feel this stress because it's like what you said, like we are at home, right? So we know that we have more hours and that we can put into our studies.
Correct. But you just don't want to.
Exactly. It's like, okay, let's say we can go out. Then we can give ourselves a break because we are traveling there, and then we have like a lunch break, then we can go out, have lunch.
And we talk to our friends during class.
Yeah, and we socialize, and then we come back and we give ourselves like time to like shower and have a meal and stuff. So it's like, in a way, we are resting our mind as well. And we are always moving and we are talking to people. So we feel like, oh, we are doing something. So it feels like the whole day is so productive.
Correct.
But then like when we are at home, right, we are only facing ourselves.
I'm literally just in my chair for the whole day.
Same.
I eat there, I stand in there. Oh. I watch the shows there.
Yeah.
And then I feel like I've been in this chair for 12 hours. I feel like I haven't done anything.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's the movement that gives you a break, kind of like to help you differentiate between morning study time. You move around a bit, then you go have your meal.
It's like, cause I understand people will tell you like you need to have a routine.
Oh, there's tissue there.
Okay.
Can I just say the pesto is very good?
It's good.
It's so good. 我忍了很久才讲.
Hey, this is
very creamy. I love it. 我吃到第一口我就想讲很好吃啊.
Yeah, just say.
It's so good. At first when we saw this, when we saw on the menu, it was 30 bucks. And then my first reaction to Kain was like, wow, 很贵.
很贵. 30块.
Does it justify the 30 bucks? I think if we have it there in the restaurant, maybe, because it charges service tax. But it's nice.
Maybe it's warm and just cooked there.
It's nice, but 30 bucks may be a bit too much. Like. Mm. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Anyways, 刚才讲到哪里? Nice. Oh, yeah, routine. Routine. People will tell you a way to cope with like not being overwhelmed by stress. Having a routine so that you're doing 你一直会 do something different, not just like sitting there and like doing one thing. 就是要 discipline 一点啊, and do different kinds of things.
Like plan ahead your time.
Plan ahead your time.
Schedule time for this activity.
Yeah, so that you won't feel like you're not doing anything and staying stagnant. But I think doesn't work for me.
Oh, you tried?
I tried. I mean, I do have a routine ever since like MCO started. Breakfast, study or other stuff. Like before uni, it was my drawing and rebuilding you stuff, right? Then lunch, then work again, then dinner, then work again. Wait, there's no break.
No wonder.
Oh yeah. Maybe that's why. Yeah. Maybe the reason why I like to like procrastinate is because I don't allocate myself a time to
break.
Oh,
I think that's important.
Yeah, I think that's why. Because I don't allocate a specific time called break time. So I take breaks in between.
By yourself.
By myself whenever I want to. Maybe. Maybe. Okay, I solved my own problem. I think under-stimulation is also a thing.
It is.
Because well, like you said, humans are social animals, right? And like being alone, isolated for a very long time, it can really like
bring your mood down.
Bring your mood down, yes. Yeah, I think I feel very under-stimulated at home. Do you feel very under-stimulated?
Yes.
Like there's not much happening.
Yeah, especially during MCO, like I think about for a month in July. I was having a break, so like there was nothing for me to do, and I was just staying home every day. So,
变成废柴, 变down.
其实我不 down, 我很开心, 因为 like I finally got time to do whatever I want. It's just that after I finish whatever I want, there's nothing else for me to do. Then I feel like I'm kind of wasting my time. But I know I should do like edit rebuilding new videos and stuff like that, right? Or like apply for internships, but 我没有那个 urgency.
Yeah.
Because I have so much time. Yeah. So I'm just like I don't even know what I do. Yeah. It's just like I just pass my time.
Yeah. Yeah. 我觉得很好诶.
But I feel like at home, even if I'm not feeling down, right, which is a good thing, but my emotions are like very stagnant. But if I go out and meet my friends, like, oh, it's like, oh, 你突然间很开心啊, 你整个人,
I觉得 like, that's very important also.
Yes.
You know what I was thinking during last month when I was like a bit chaotic, FYP HCA, 我会有时候, I will think like, I should feel urgent. Why am I not feeling urgent? Then I don't feel urgent, but I'm at the same time also guilt tripping myself into feeling urgent. Then I'm stressing myself out for not stressing out.
Yes.
It's so unhealthy to do that to yourself, honestly. I think that we should believe in ourselves more. Like if it's not stressing you out, maybe it's because you know that you're prepared, or like you know that you can handle it. Yeah. So don't have to like guilt trip yourself.
And also I think we are like used to it. We are used to feeling stressed all the
time. Yeah.
So if we're not stressed, we think like something is wrong.
Yes. 真的.
Which is very unhealthy.
That's true. And then I think I started doing something else as well, which is creating a sleep hygiene. Yeah, means like have a routine before bedtime.
Oh.
Yeah, do something that will calm you down and sort of like unwind yourself.
Oh, is that why you bought the candle?
Yeah, that's why I bought the candle. Because I wanted to have something to do before bed instead of like 立刻做完 assignment, 关电脑, then 就跳进去床上. Because I told you I couldn't sleep well, right?
Yeah.
Like before I went to Malacca, and then I couldn't sleep well, and even if I fell asleep very fast, right, I would wake up after like 4 or 5 hours of sleep. And when I wake up, it's very scary, you know. It's like I'm alert after I wake up. It's not like I'm still sleepy eye and like groggy and stuff. When I wake up, right, it's like I'm awake, you know. 我的心就跳得很快了。And then 我觉得就是这样子的东西啦。I'm not sure what to call it, but I wake up like that.
是因为你 like you're very anxious.
Yeah.
Subconsciously, so
yeah. Yeah, it 就是一直在我的脑里面, mm-hmm. 然后 that's why 我就想要分清楚什么是 study time, 什么是 rest time. Because we're always at home, like we said, right? I feel like 那个很多东西都会 mash up together. Yeah. There's no such thing as rest time and work time anymore. It's just work time.
It just increases the stress even more. Like you're already stressed that you're home all the time with the pandemic outside.
Yeah. And then you have to stress over uni and your future and shit. Oh my god. Yeah. So yeah, sleep routine. I know that Kai also has a routine.
Yeah.
You want to share about yours first?
I just started mine. Okay, during MCO, I was like living my best life. I was like, my mom was baking every single day, like different kind of like cakes and like muffins and stuff. And then, so I was like eating every day, and I was like, Jeremy, I was like sitting on my chair the whole day.
The whole day.
So I was literally like eating, sitting, sleeping, pooping, eating on repeat every single day. Mm-hmm. And then, yeah, then like after that, I kind of like 反省一下, like I look at myself in the mirror and I was like, oh my god, I'm so fat. Like at time, I really like 整个身体很 bloated 这样. And I was like, oh my god, 不可以了, I need to 反省一下.
你有没有很不舒服?
No, but every meal, I would eat until I'm full. And then throughout the day, I would snack. Because my mom bakes mah, so I would just like keep eating that thing until I finish, and then the next day she'll bake again. And so like I'm literally eating the whole day, and then I'm just sitting there. So yeah, and I felt like very sluggish. So I told myself like no, I should like pull myself together. And like Jamin mentioned that she did exercise like 6 times a week last time.
4, 5 to 6, sometimes 4 when I'm lazy.
Yeah, and when I first heard that, I was like, like I cannot imagine exercising like so many times, you know. But then I was like, okay, I told myself I need to do this. So like I went online and I searched workout routines.
很多耶, you'd be surprised. Yeah. There's so many on YouTube.
There's really a lot. So I wanted something longer, like 1 month. And then I found this YouTuber, her name is Amy Wong.
Yeah,
she's a Hong Kong fitness YouTuber. And her videos are like, I saw the comments, a lot of people say like, oh, it really works for them. So I was like, okay, let's try. She has a 4-week challenge. So I've been doing it. So now this is my 24th day. I have 4 more days until I complete it. Yeah. So and also like I told myself that I wanted to sleep early and wake up early. So by 11 o'clock I would be on my bed already. Like I would switch off my phone and then like try to go to sleep. And then I would wake up about, last time in the beginning I would wake up at 7. And then I would meditate do the abundance meditation for I think 15 minutes, that meditation. And then so you have like a good mind space already, and then you go for your workout, and like you're putting your body into good sweat, and then like it will trigger the serotonin and stuff like that to make you feel good. So like you're sweating and feeling good, and then you have a nice refreshing shower, and then like you have a good breakfast, and it just kind of like sets the tone for the whole day.
Yeah.
So you feel like very energized, and you feel this accomplishment that wow, I did so much in just
the first hour that I got up.
So like you feel so proud of yourself and like have some self-satisfaction, and then you feel like, okay, I can do this, I can like get through the day.
Yeah.
So yeah, that really helped to like give my life some structure and give me something to look forward to. And also it's a way for me to like, actually I ask myself like, why do I want to work out so hard? I never tried to work out every day. And I thought like, oh, is it because I feel like I'm too fat or what? Am I doing this for other people? But then I realized it's actually I'm doing this to like prove to myself that I can do this, like I can achieve what I want, and it's sort of like a small achievement every day. And I realized that every time I, like from the beginning of her workout, right, I was dying. I, like her workout is like 45 seconds and then 10 seconds rest like that, and I couldn't get through the whole 45 seconds. But then like by week 2, week 3, I can actually feel the difference in my own body.
You feel stronger.
Like, I feel stronger. And like even like my stamina is better.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was so happy in the change of myself. So yeah, I think I'll just like keep it up. I hope I can make this into like my lifestyle.
And I think you can. It's already been 24 days.
Yeah. And I just like, because I'm completing her challenge already. So I'll just look for something else.
Yeah, I think from what we said, right, 我们两个都是讲 either have a routine when you wake up or have a routine when you go to sleep. One is because it sets your intention, and then the second one helps you fall asleep easier if you're having a bit difficulty falling asleep. I find it to work very well.